Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing.
All right, we're back to Life is Strange Before the Storm, and oh god, well, looks like the fire is done, possibly. Look at that area smolder. That was the park, wasn't it? Oh god, there's nothing left. All right, well, let's see what's going on. Last time we left off, we had basically made peace with David, and it seems like me and Rachel were probably gonna get ourselves in trouble once more, because Frank wants to know what happened to the money, and we're trying to find the smiling lady, which happens to be her mom, and there's all kinds of shit going on. Where is our journey gonna take us next?
Work with me here.
Ah, yes. We must try to fix the truck. That's right.
Damn it!
That's gonna leave a mark.
Better. But still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just need to find the right tool for each problem.
All right, so we have a socket wrench. What's this thing? Turn on? Oh, it's the radio. Okay. Yeah, why not? Let's turn on some tunes. All right. So somebody messaged us on our phone. Oh, yeah, we haven't read these in a while. Should I do that? Should I wait a little while before I read it? Yeah, I think I will. I'm not going to start off with reading because that's boring. But you know what? I will read that actually quite soon. Didn't they add a new picture? Yeah, Sarah. Is there any information? Oh, yeah, there is. All right. I'm not going to read this, but if you guys want to pause it, you can actually sit here and read it yourself. But I want to try to cut the reading to a minimum, unless you guys enjoy that, in which case I don't have a problem reading it, but I don't know how interesting that is for people to watch, so you guys will have to let me know. But in the meantime, let's check out our phone. Oh, well, we have a bunch of messages. All right, well, let's start with her mom. Chloe, I'm leaving the door unlocked in case you don't have your key. Please come home. Doesn't matter that it's after curfew. Mom, I can't right now. Please? Is that now, or is that, like, previously? I'm not sure. Victoria. I don't remember reading any of this. I heard some fucked up shit from Nathan about you. Who do you think you are? What did we do to Nathan? We were actually nice to Nathan. Why are you hating on us, man? Doesn't matter. We're gonna still be nice to Nathan even if he is acting out. He doesn't need you. You dumb fuck up.
Need me?
Oh, yeah, because of us standing up for him, basically, at the beginning. Go back to your trailer. Well, that's uncalled for. By the way, Rachel Amber obviously played you last night. You'll be lucky if she ever talks to you again. Oh shit, why didn't I see that? I'm so hurt. You only knew, Victoria. This is just the beginning, bitch. So I was right all along. Rachel Amber is fucking evil, bitch. Oh yeah, she totally is. I guess you think you're her, like, little sidekick now. Yep. I've had it with this school. Nobody gave a shit about me last night. It was all Rachel. Yeah, I don't blame her. I mean, fucking Rachel fucked her up with whatever she gave her in that drink. Like, what the fuck? Even I think that was a little fucked up. A little more than she probably should have done, although I can understand why Victoria is kind of a bitch towards her. You saw what she wrote on the mirror towards the beginning of the game on, like, the back of the mirror. I don't know why I'm telling you this, because now you're alone and regret being a bitch to me. That's not true. How dare you? Damn! Close shots fired. You called it on the... Man, if you didn't just read her mind, she's like, no, that's not true. Yeah, it is. We both know it. Damn, and that's her last text, too. Group message? Oh, it's about the play. Okay, cool. Rachel and Chloe, where are you guys? We're at the Tempest cast party. I already texted Rachel like 8 times. Oh yeah, they were with us. We were together that night. Hey, I don't think we're making it. Chloe, you should come, heart. Yeah, Chloe, you did awesome, babe. Aw, thanks, Hayden. Hey, Chloe, great job tonight. Thanks. Thanks, I can't. But you totally saved us. Without you, there would have been no show. Seriously, just come. Bring Rachel. Sorry, guys. Do you guys care more about Rachel than Chloe, or are you just, like, you loving up on both of them? I can't tell. Here's Rachel. Let's see what she's saying. Okay, thank you for being there for me last night. I'm feeling a lot better. Guess what? I'm a good kisser? Okay, that. Also, we're meeting Frank at the junkyard in 2 hours. I think he can get us in touch with Sarah. Holy shit. Yep, I'm still at my house, just showering, then grabbing tools for the truck. So, meet at the junkyard? I'll be there. You're amazing, Chloe Price. Hopefully we don't get you in trouble. I don't feel good about this. Hey, David texts us. Let's not get ourselves in trouble, all right? Let's see. Chloe, this is David. Yeah, I kind of figured from the picture. Did my mom give you my number? Yes, she did. I noticed you took your father's toolbox. Are you working on a project? Sort of. What kind of project? Jeez, what happened to trusting me? No, I was just asking. Glad to see you taking an interest in something. Keep it up. Aw, you see? If anything, that's the David that you need to see. Like, if any parents are watching this, take notes, all right? This is the kind of shit you need to know when it comes to your kids, all right? You need to be nice to them, you need to get to know them, and you need to trust them. Even if you shouldn't trust them, you should trust them to a degree, because when you ruin that trust, they're not going to come to you when they have a problem. David's doing everything right now. You can't watch your kids 24/7. You got to trust them to a degree. You got to teach them the difference between right and wrong, and then set a good example. Don't be one of those parents that's like a smoker and then says, well, you're not allowed to smoke, or you shouldn't do that, you're too young. That motherfucker set a good example. Can't be doing that. You look like a hypocrite. Be saying shit like that. Do as I say, not as I do. That's not how that works. All right, I think that's everybody, but I'm impressed with David. I have a feeling he's going to get mad at us later, but I hope not. I hope we can stay on the straight and narrow. If anything, you want to impress him and not hurt him when he believes in you.
I can definitely see some problems.
See how that shit works?
Just need to match them to the right tool.
All right, manual.
It's not like I need a manual, but I'm really glad it's here.
Man, I do. I don't know shit about engines. I mean, I know what some of these parts are, but man, if I had to try to fix this, man, we wouldn't be getting nowhere. Let's see, radiator cap, battery post, check.
Hell yeah! Fantastic.
We're about to play. It's pretty loose. How can I tighten it?
What I want you to do is crank that stereo up as loud as it goes. If anyone complains, what do you tell them, Skip?
This had rules.
Nailed it.
Much better. The distributor cap looks pretty gross. I need something small to scrape the gunk off the cap.
It's probably the screwdriver, right? Oh, this is neat, so we can kind of like check things as we go and pick it up. The screwdriver should work to scrape shit off, right?
That should help keep shit distributed. Well, fuck.
Plug it back in, bud.
Go back from whence you came.
message, didn't we? Okay, some of these I think we already saw, but let's check it anyway. It's basically about the fire weather update, air quality health advisory, Arcadia Bay Forest Watch, Arcadia Bay, blah, 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 accumulation state park fire remains active, moderate to heavy smoke expected, limit outdoor activity. I mean, would being inside really help with that if you have, like, you know, air sucking into your house via your AC? I mean, realistically?
Maybe something's wrong with the battery post.
Probably corroded,
this
right?
This connection is pretty shaky.
Oh,
I could
loose.
Fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it.
You could use a screwdriver for that, can't you? But I don't know for sure. I think so. Depends on how it's set up.
This connection is pretty shaky.
Oh, whoops.
I could fix this battery post if I could get a good enough grip on it.
Meant to use screwdriver.
Won't do anything.
Oh, okay. Well, that shows how much I know about trucks. Alright, let's see. Pliers. Yeah, that makes sense. Pliers.
There. Fits like a deadly electric glove.
Check.
This thing seems pretty gunked up.
Don't
I think
hair,
I should
man.
Move on to something else.
Okay. Let's check this.
This thing is gunked the fuck up.
And how do we fix that is the question. Where is it at? Oh, right here. Blow? Does that really make much difference, you think?
Maybe.
Oh.
Sick.
Well, that worked. I figured an air compressor would have worked better, but I mean, hell. Nice lungs, Chloe, damn. I didn't think that'd be enough pressure, but alright.
Spark plugs busted. Carbon deposits. Of course.
But just carbon? I don't know if the car's gonna have the right size or not, but. Was that our dad's car? Or is it just a random one? Oh, you see that fire in the background, though? Man.
Please. I need you.
Shit, we got it started, though. What about the air intake pipe, though? We didn't check that yet.
Yeah.
Seeing Chloe happy. You don't see that too often.
Hey, Junkyard Queen, where are you at? Hey. Holy shit. Your hair. It's so...
badass.
I was gonna say hot. But yeah, badass too. Hey, not sure if you saw, but someone moved your truck.
No way.
Should we check it out?
Hey, Price. Nice wheels.
Thanks, Frank.
You're early, Frank. What's the occasion?
It's his fucking bar mitzvah. Frank here's becoming a man. Aren't you, big guy?
What's he doing here?
What do you think? We're not dealing with a couple of dime bags anymore, Chloe. Where's the money?
Yeah, insult him. That's a good idea. I don't have it.
For fuck's sake, the money wasn't there. What do you want from me?
I don't think she has it.
Oh? It's cute how she acts like you two are friends. You heard what happened to Drew, right? Maybe try keeping that in mind when you talk to me.
Oh,
don't fucking
shit.
Touch her.
Not a good idea, Rachel. I appreciate it, but probably not a good idea.
Why is it that chicks think it's okay to hit me? But if I lay a single finger on them, suddenly, it's a whole other thing.
Technically, you touched us first, man. So your logic's kind
of
bullshit.
Frank says you were asking about a client of his. That true?
Yeah, I mean, lying at this point is not a good idea, because if he thinks we're lying about one thing, then we're going to be lying about something else, so...
Yeah, it's true. I don't see why you should give a shit.
You don't? Maybe I'll show you. See, you two Nancy Drews decided it would be a good idea to call your drug dealer and ask about his business. I didn't go to a fancy academy. But that doesn't strike me as smart. Maybe it was this man's sunny disposition that confused you. But he's got a whole other side to him that I don't think you'd like. Should we let them see it?
We're just talking here.
Okay, then let's talk. I want to know right now why you give a shit about this woman.
I'm not gonna lie to him, because lying to him is not gonna end well for us. I already know what like better about this kind of shit. You lie to somebody like this and they find out otherwise, it's gonna go down here real quick.
She's a friend. An old family friend.
This chick doesn't have any family. Or any friends.
That's not true.
Look, none of this matters. All we care about is that you stop asking questions. Got it.
No. Tell me where she is. Now, Rachel.
Wait a minute. No way.
What the fuck is your
Rachel? As in Rachel Amber? That makes so much sense. This is James Amber's fucking kid.
Damon,
shit.
Your dad's a real piece of shit, you know?
Oh, we know.
We're aware. Not sure what that has to do with us.
Me neither. But I'd like to find out. Here's what happens next. Thank you.
Come on, man. They're just kids.
No, they're not. This one is the fucking DA's daughter. And right now, she's going to fill me in on what her daddy is up to and how he's connected to that whore everyone's asking about.
Damon, calm down. We're still talking.
I get why he
still
wants
cool.
To know. No.
We need to get
no,
crazy.
Rachel. Oh, that was a bad move. That was a really bad move. You might as well have just told the dude.
You fucking bitch.
Oh, shit.
Rachel!
Oh, fuck.
What the fuck? Chloe, go! Now!
Hold on.
Shit.
Hey! Hold on, okay? Rachel? No.
Man, put some pressure on that shit.
I'm not losing you.
Man, see, he thinks... Why would the DEA or DA's daughter be digging for him? Like, that doesn't even make sense. Like... Criminals aren't real bright, but I mean, come on, man. You should know what better than that. Like, what, his 16-year-old daughter or 17 or whatever she is digging for information for him? Like, really? You think that? Like, what is this person to you? Man, you could just ask questions, although Rachel shouldn't have tried to hit him from behind. That's just a bad move. I mean, Rachel, you seem smarter than that. Like, what the fuck? I get he's an asshole, but like... Oh, man. Be better off if we had given them the money. Rachel wouldn't have gotten hurt. But then Drew would have got fucked over. Man, this is one of those no right answer kind of things. Man, we need to fucking tell David what the fuck's going on. His ass fucking military beat his ass with some shit.
Rachel is going to be all right. The knife damaged her brachial artery, but didn't cut it. She's out of surgery, and now she's resting. Chloe, what happened?
I'm trying to figure that out. It's my fault. I'm gonna straight up, I don't know if it's our fault or not, technically, because Rachel kind of went off on her own, but...
It's my fault. I should have listened to you. I even saw your file saying Sarah was connected to Damon Merrick.
I know exactly who Damon Merrick is.
He fucking did it. I'm gonna straight up
tell
you.
Start over and tell me everything. Did you and Rachel try to contact Sarah? I'm not going to chastise or blame you, Chloe. But I need the whole story.
I'm gonna trust you, honestly, because I think you care about your daughter, although
so
I think you're crooked.
I got my dealer to meet us, since he knows Sarah.
Frank Bowers.
Yeah, that's right. But Damon showed up with him.
What did Merrick want?
He to ask about Sarah. Yes. Wait.
He asked us why we were so interested in Sarah.
And what did you say?
Nothing, of course.
Is that how it became violent?
He wanted dirt on you, and Rachel got angry both.
When he found out Rachel was the DA's daughter, he wanted information about you.
And how did he know that I'm her father?
Maybe he already knew. He did already know. We didn't say anything. Did we? No, we didn't. Pretty sure. Hang on. Yeah, we didn't say anything. We just said, yeah, he's a douche. So yeah, I think he already knew.
I don't know. Maybe he's seen her before.
What happened next?
Damon had a knife out. We all could see it. But then he said something that pissed Rachel off. And she just grabbed a piece of wood and hit him. And then he stabbed her. I keep thinking that maybe I could have done something, but when he attacked her, I just froze.
It's not your fault.
And Frank held him off so we could get to the truck. I heard a scream, but I don't know what happened. And then we were here.
I appreciate you telling me the truth.
Damn straight, dude. Just ain't the time to be holding back like that, because we didn't do anything wrong. Technically, we didn't take the money, didn't do anything wrong. I mean, what about Damon? What about Sarah? Fuck Sarah. Sarah doesn't even important right now. Fucking, what about Damon? Like, what the fuck are we gonna do about his crazy ass?
What are you going to do about Damon?
Find out if he is alive, first of all.
Hopefully not.
My department's been after him for some time. I was told that if Rachel had arrived only a few minutes later, she might not have, Thank you, Chloe. You saved my world. It will be some time before Rachel wakes up. I promise. I'll let you know when she does.
Okay. Thanks.
Despite him maybe being crooked, I will tell you this. I think he might be just undercover, but even though I think something about him is crooked, he seems like a decent enough guy for his daughter. He does care about his daughter. That much I don't have to question, at least.
Hey.
Steph. How's Drew?
Pretty good. Miss Amber just told me Rachel's going to be okay. I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Well, our room's just down the hall. You should come by.
Okay. Sure. Definitely.
The guy with the phone.
I don't think I can sit still any longer. Might as well stretch my legs while I wait for Rachel to wake up.
Man, what an emotional fucking... Wait, whoa, what's happening?
Shit. I know those guys.
This doesn't look like the maternity wing.
You think? If you're this useless now, what are you gonna do at 3 a.m. when the baby needs...
There's a sign for the prenatal class.
Great. I guess that's your contribution for today.
Those people suck.
How do you know them? I don't recognize them, Chloe. I was gonna go down here and check stuff. I'm glad I didn't, like, start any of the action. I'm not leaving. I just kinda wanna... Yeah, there we go. Look.
This poster seems to be missing some context. What to draw?
No more graffiti. Although I like seeing your art because you're quite talented. We ain't be graffitiing stuff. They didn't do nothing wrong. And even if they did, does that make it right? I mean, if we could just graffiti random shit, that'd be more fun to me. Sit.
Being in a hospital this long sucks. I just want Rachel to wake up, and then I'll feel better. I owe Frank big time. Can't believe he did that for us. I hope he's okay. Not like I can do anything about it one way or the other. And what about Damon? Is he gonna come after us? I actually feel better knowing that James Amber is on his case. Ugh. That's weird.
You know, he's the guy we stole a shirt from at the very beginning of the game, isn't it? The guy with the car that was parked backwards that we fucked up and made it roll down a hill. I don't feel too bad about rolling it down the hill, but I think to myself, the money that Chloe got from him is the money he used to pay off Frank. And if he ever finds out, he might think Frank did it, which is gonna put Frank at risk. Man, this game tests you. I mean, admittedly, I did it more so because I wanted to see what would happen. Now I'm starting to think that might have some really far-reaching consequences.
One more hour of waiting, and I would have read that.
Let's just never... Wait, what was that? Oh, mini golf.
If I want to stay sane, I need to stay busy. What's there to do around here?
Let's not put the Firewalk shirt on, because if we run into that guy, he might be like, hey, I remember you. You wanted a shirt. How the hell did you get that if you didn't pay for it?
From the secret shadows of dawn, there's a darkness to disguise. The simple thought I recognize.